Ideas are very rarely born just in a single person's mind. The best ideas are collaborative ideas.
Voor de introductie in de klinische neuropsychologie moesten we filmpjes maken en daar elkaar feedback op geven. Wat waren de concrete punten waar we feedback op moesten geven? Nou, dan geef je scoren van 1 tot 5. En opvallende scores moest je dan even vertellen waarom. Normaal als je algemeen feedback geeft, dan zeg je van nou, het was heel mooi, heel goed. Misschien moet je daaraan denken. En nu omdat je concreet op die punten kun je niet zeggen dat dat goed was, als dat niet goed was. Dus dan leer je op die punten specifiek feedback te geven.
Peer feedback and assessment is a window to metacognition. And metacognition is the awareness of your learning state. If you are not aware of your learning state, that is what you know and what you need to know, then you cannot direct your learning.
Men is vaak gewend aan rustig in de collegebanken zitten en luisteren wat de docent vertelt. Maar op het moment dat studenten het doen, tenminste dat is ook mijn persoonlijke ervaring, en zelf actief worden in het onderwijs, dan zie je ze ook meer gaan genieten, laat ik zo zeggen. En worden de leerdoelen inderdaad echt beter bereikt.
If you don't know where you're at in terms of your learning state, then you don't know where to go next.
Students, throughout their lives, never receive direct instruction on how to learn.
You need to have a session or two with students to teach them how to give that effective feedback, which means that you also have to know how to give effective feedback yourself.
The author really liked that.
The key part of the peer feedback is to have a rubric.
And rubrics are frameworks to help signal to students where you would like them to be, but also when you engage in the peer feedback, it can help cue them to where they are at in their learning state.
So basically, we're having them ask the same questions that we ask as well. So is this a convincing problem diagnosis? Are the conclusions appropriate? And that helps to guide the students in what to look for and what to give feedback on.
If we were exchanging a paper and I said, you're great, you're a great writer, this is awesome, that's person-specific feedback. And that's not very helpful to helping students move along a curve or a journey in learning. So what you want to help students do is provide content-based and effort-based feedback.
That will mean that you can only cover, say, the general development overview.
Peer feedback is so important in the modern world because that is the reality of what students will be engaging in when they leave the university.
En dat je dan bij wijze van spreken zelf de radar moet ontwikkelen voor het ontvangen van feedback. Maar ook inderdaad dat je in situaties later terechtkomt waarin van jou verlangd wordt om die feedback te geven.
So when you are engaging in peer feedback, one of the things that you can that often happens is that you gain ideas that you wouldn't have thought of before.
Ja, ik denk dat wij als Nederlanders in de Nederlandse cultuur, het Nederlands onderwijs, bij wijze van spreken vanaf de kleuterschool gewend zijn om feedback te ontvangen in ieder geval. Misschien ook wel feedback te geven. Nederlanders zijn vrij direct en dat is denk ik voor het onderwijs heel erg goed.
Ideas are very rarely born just in a single person's mind. They're often the best ideas are collaborative ideas. And if you can't give effective feedback or you can't receive effective feedback, then you're not going to be able to be a part of of changing the future.
Downside of it's good they refer to the class.
It can be very difficult for us to put ourselves in the students' shoes, and we may miss things that are important to help guide that learning. This is called the expert blind spot.
If your peers can't understand what you're writing, if they can't understand what you're trying to say, then you know that there's something that should be improved.
One of the greatest benefits of peer feedback for us is that it can help us address that expert blind spot.
Door peer feedback ben je beter in staat om ook persoonlijke feedback te leveren aan studenten dan een docent bijvoorbeeld met een college van 100 studenten ooit kan doen.
When there's many students writing assignments, papers, providing detailed feedback on all of those, especially in the short time periods in which these courses run, is almost impossible.
Right.
We train students to also look critically at the work they do, at the work that others do, and I think that those are also useful skills to teach them.
ja, het is wel iets wat ik vaker zou willen doen. Voornamelijk omdat ik dan te zien krijg wat andere mensen inleveren. Dan heb je wat vergelijkingsmateriaal.
Having a peer feedback system makes for better courses, it makes for better teaching. And these are useful skills they should develop.